And it's the worst kind of freaks that love this shit, which is 5,000 likes in 2 hours, dude. 5,000 likes. Well, I did. I watched his entire fucking video. What is this? I understand he's in a lot of stress. Lots of people have been piling on him, me included, over his Ukraine takes. Such takes of his are a product of his simplistic American lefty streamer bro views being thrown into the vortex of nuance that is Europe. Worse, a European armed conflict. Yeah. I simply, as an American streamer bro leftist, cannot understand the complexities of arming Nazis and training them. It's, oh, you fool. You just do not understand. You do not understand. I'm a European and you're a non-European. So you don't understand the complexities of arming and training Nazis. You know, I did grow up in Turkey, so I do have a different perspective than I guess he does on NATO involvement. But I don't know. I mean, I personally do not favor an institution that literally fucking ripped ultra-nationalist violence through the country that I grew up in. But hey, but that's not a European country. Isn't that right? Hungary, on the other hand, is, you know? That's firmly planted in Europe, whereas Turkey is not. A lot of Muslims in Turkey. Never going to be a European country, despite its, you know, despite Istanbul being in fucking Europe. Hey, fine. As a European myself, this is, of course, nothing new to me, which is why I've been able to make these detailed, nuanced points of view. Oh, God. Does it hurt when you're cranking yourself so hard here? Even when it comes to actual neo-Nazis in Ukraine, instead of the expected knee-jerk dismissal and denunciation. Oh, you fool. He literally is saying, like, you fool.
Cool.
You do not have a nuanced approach to neo-Nazis being armed. I, as a European, on the other hand, I do. People who aren't familiar with the complexities of Europe and Ukraine, and especially the current war, might find those takes of mine scary at first, which I understand. Disingenuous people might even say that I was defending Nazis in my video, The Guerrilla Institute. But this is, of course, not the case. People who say that are either lying or haven't watched the actual video. Hassan didn't mean to insult me. He simply reached the narrow limits of his understanding of the world. Dude, I literally... Dude. I can't do this. The narrow limits. Yeah, dude. Just fucking say I'm a Turk roach with a cockroach brain and move on, okay? Yeah, fuck it. I'm saying it, dude, okay? This motherfucker, not exactly out of the alt-right pipe, pipeline, okay? Straight up, dude. Let's go. Yeah, after watching your fucking Nazi apologia video, where you literally, in the most semantic, the most, like, nitpicky way, said that the Gravel Institute was wrong, even when they literally contradicted your statements, where you used faulty fucking data and engaged in Nazi apologia, you turn around with this Eurocentric supremacist trash. It seems as though you do not have a problem with aligning with Nazis as long as you're fighting against a larger imperial force. That's precisely what you've said time and time again. I like to think about, with my narrow Turk roach brain who can't comprehend the pan-Euro supremacist attitude, look to historical precedent with my narrow-minded streamer bro American-centric brain, okay? I just simply cannot understand what it would be like if violent paramilitaries were justified, defended, and armed and trained. But of course, what do I know? I simply cannot understand the nuance and the complexities of a person who literally looked at America arming and funding and training Nazis and said, well, those guns actually just simply ended up in the hands of the Nazis. So technically, that's really different. Dude, I read the post from him before. The nuclear war is not that bad. Ad hominem equals him losing the argument. Yeah, god damn. Hassan didn't mean to insult me. He's just too stupid to understand he was insulting me. Because I have the nuance. I have the nuance of defending Nazis. And then I look at all these fucking horny, westoid, angloid-brained, disgusting filth in the chat. Oh, man, that's a sick burn, bro. You fucking killed him. We tactically love Nazis, actually. Yeah, you fucking killed him, dude.
Adam SSP Pogiggle.
Neoliberal debate lords, dude. Yeah, not surprising that they would fucking align with Nazis like this. I mean, he is pro-NATO, so of course he is literally tactically going to align with Nazis over USSR involvement in Europe. So we know that already, which is the history of NATO, riddled with it, many such cases. For all these years, he had others like him were able to surf the waves of Bernie Sanders, a person with an actually overarching political philosophy and nuanced worldview. By attaching themselves to Bernie's correct points, these commentators were able to conceal that all their views are just a variation of the 3-4 half-baked, disjointed ideas in lieu of a coherent set of values and an understanding of the world outside of America. Trying to scale these views... Dude, I'm literally Turkish. Does this fucking idiot think I, like, grew up in America or something? This is the most disgusting thing I've ever shown you. I mean, this is TOS violation. This is literally a fucking... This is literally a baby-brained idiot jerking off over his really just idiotic fucking assessment here that shows a gigantic blind spot, okay? The gigantic blind spot is that you just don't care about fucking Nazis because they're not going to kill you, I think. That's what you think. U.S. bad isn't a political philosophy. It's an ontological foundation. First of all, the U.S. is bad. Like, the idea that it's not bad is fucking so stupid. The fuck do you know? With the war in Ukraine, Hassan, like many other American lefties, brought to a humiliating realization. U.S. bad is not a political philosophy. U.S. bad is... true, okay? Might not be a political philosophy, but it is fucking true.